What is socialism? Socialism means common ownership. Common ownership means everybody having the right to participate in decisions or how global resources will be used. History of socialism. Socialism has its origins in the French Revolution of 1789 and the changes brought about by the Industrial Revolution. The French Revolution opened up by the possibilities of creating a dramatic change in the way in which society was structured. Socialism in Europe. Student, this is the map of Europe. How socialism spread in Europe, we can see in this chapter. The beginning. Sudden change in the society occurred after the French Revolution, which was dominated by the church and the aristocracy and divided into estates and orders. The European society was divided into liberals, radicals and conservatives, mostly three parts. Now we can learn about liberals. Who are liberals? The liberals are those who wanted a nation that could tolerate all religion as people. They approached to elected parliamentary government subject to laws and not ruler. But they felt only men of property have the right to vote. Next is radicals. Radicals, they dislike concentration of property in the hand of a few. The radical, those who wanted a government based on the majority of the population. They oppose the privileges of great landowners and wealthy factory owners. Last is conservatives. Who are conservatives? Conservatives are those who felt that changes should be brought forth slowly, but at the same time, the past should also be respected. Now we can see the rise of socialism. By the mid-19th century, socialism became popular and attracted many in Europe. Robert O. Louis Bank and of French, Karl Marx was some of the great socialists of this time. When the socialist idea spread in Europe, they formed the Second International, an international body to coordinate their efforts. In Germany, the association worked very closely with the Socialist Democratic Party, which helped the party to win the seats in the parliamentary election. The socialist and the trade unionist performed Labour Party in the year 1905 in England. Socialist reformers. Robert O. 14th May 1771 to 17 November 1858. In Britain, a Welsh textile manufacturer, a philosophist and social reformer, was one founder of the utopian socialism and the cooperative movement. He is known for efforts to improve factory working conditions for his workers and promote experimental socialistic communities. Louis Blanc, 1813 to 1882. In France, Blanc wanted that government to encourage cooperative and replace capitalist enterprises. These cooperatives were two association of people who produced goods together and divided the profits according to the work done by the members. Karl Marx, 1818 to 1883, a German philosopher and economist. He believed that to free themselves from the capitalist exploitation, workers had to construct a radically socialist society where all property was socially controlled. This would be communist society. He was convinced that workers would triumph in their conflict with capitalists. A communist society was the natural society of the future. Industrial society and social changes. Socio-economic changes. First is development of cities. Industrial area development. It was also the beginning of industrial revolution. Men, women and children were pushed into the factories. Expanding railways, industrial revolution, problems, long working hours, poor wages, unemployment, housing and sanitation problems. Liberals and radicals wanted changes, as they were educated and owners of some factories were wanted more profits. But liberals and radicals, workers under aristocracy and conservatives resigned. Established in Europe after 1815. Support of socialism in Europe. Socialists were against private property and saw it was the root of social evils. They had different visions of future. Some believed in cooperatives. Some demanded that government must encourage cooperatives. Socialists formed an organization called Second International to spread socialist ideas. Workers in the Germany and England began forming association to fight for better living conditions. In Germany, Britain and France, these workers formed associations. In Germany, these associations worked closely with Social Democratic Party and helped it win parliamentary elections. Seats by till 1905 could not form the government. It set up funds for members in distress, reduction of working hours and right to vote. Russian Revolution, the beginning. The Russian Empire in 1914. Children, you can see a map. You can see red area in this map. This is denote the Russia. It shows the Russia. In 1914, the Russia Empire included Poland, Finland, a large part of the Transnistria. The majority of the 166 million population were slaves, but as well as Jews and Turks were dozens of other nationalists. Tsar Nicholas II ruled the Russian Empire as an absolute monarch. This is the picture of Tsar Nicholas II. Economy and society of Russia. Most of the Russian population, about 85%, were agriculturists. Industries were being set up, which was mostly private property of the industrialists. Workers were divided into groups, but they did unite to strike work when they were dissatisfied. Peasants had no respect for nobility. Very unlike the French peasant. Russian peasants were the only peasants community which pooled their land and their commune divide it. All political parties were legal in Russia before 1914. The Russian Socialist Democratic Labour Party was formed in 1898. It struggled to give peasants their rights over land that belonged to nobles. As land was divided among the peasants periodically, which makes them natural socialists, and it was felt that the peasants and not workers would be the main source of revolution. But Lenin did not agree with this, as he felt that peasants were not one social group. The party was divided into Bolsheviks and Mensheviks. There are some differences between these parties, Bolsheviks and Mensheviks. First, we read about the Mensheviks. The Mensheviks represented a minority group under the leadership of Alexander Kerensky, and the Bolshevik under their leadership Lenin constituted a majority of the socialists. Mensheviks, they believed in gradual changes and establishment of parliamentary form of government like that of France and Britain. Bolsheviks, they wanted to work for revolution. They favored a disciplined party to control the members and the quality of its members. Mensheviks, they favored a party which was open to all to work within the system. Bolsheviks, they wanted to make the party an instrument for bringing about the revolution. Condition of workers in Russia. Workers in Russia were divided by skill. Metal workers considered themselves aristocrat among other workers. Their occupation demanded more training and skill. Women made up 30% of the factory labor force by 1914, but they were paid less than men. Division among workers showed themselves in dress and manners too. Some workers form association to help members in time of unemployment or financial hardship. Despite divisions, workers did unite to strike work when they disagree with employers about dismissal of work conditions. This was unique thing in then. 1904-1905 revolution and the event Bloody Sunday. Russian worker was deeply dissatisfied because in 1904 prices of essential goods rose so quickly that real wages declined by 20%. Their grievances aggravated when four members of the Assembly of Russian Workers were dismissed at the Putilo Iron Works. They went to strike demanding a reduction in the working days to 8 hours, an increase in wage and improvement in working conditions. When the processions of workers reached the Winter Palace, it was attacked by the police and the Cossacks. Over 100 workers were killed and about 300 wounded. This incident came to be known as Bloody Sunday. The incident had great significance in the history of Russia because it started a series of events that became known as the 1905 Revolution. Strikes took place all over the country and universities closed down. Lawyers, doctors, engineers, and other middle-class workers established the Union of Unions and demanded a constituent assembly. The rise of Russian Revolution. The rise of Russian Revolution. The incident of Bloody Sunday leads to the creation of Duma, or an elected consultative parliament in Russia. The workers finally formed an organization known as Soviet or Council. This was the Petrograd Soviet. These Soviets were, which began as committees to conduct strike, later became the instruments of political power. The incident provoked disturbance in practically every part of the country and among every social class. Section of the army and navy revolt and sympathize with the revolutionaries. The Tsar yielded a political pressure and introduced the October Manifesto, which granted freedom of speech, press and association, and conferred the power to make laws upon an elected body called the Duma. First World War and the Russian Empire. Student, as you know that the First World War started 1914 to 1918. The timing of the First World War is 1914 to 1918. There are two powers that we can call Central Power and Allied Power. Central Power had Germany, Austria, Turkey, and Allied Power had France, Britain, Italy, Romania, or Russia. You can see in this map, yellow power, triple entities in pink color, central powers, and blue color in neutral. They are not in any group. The First World War and Russian Empire. Initially, the war was supported by people of Russia, means they supported to Tsar. Over the period of time, support to Tsar went down. Reason: Tsar refused to consult the main parties in Duma. Rasputin, monk and advisor of Tsar, made aristocracy unpopular. Tsarina Alexandra was German origin. More casualties were more on Russian front, as it has plain area. Defeat were shocking and demoralizing. Impact of First World War on Russia. Russian army lost badly with Germany and Austria. About 7 million casualties by 1917. Destruction of crops and buildings by Russian army leads over 3 million refugees in Russia. Soldiers did not wish to fight such a war. It also had a severe impact on industry, as German control of Baltic Sea, by which Russian cut off from supplies of machineries to industries. This war adversely affected industries. Railway line began to break in 1916. Some small workshops producing essential were shut down due to labor shortage, and as a result, by winners 1916, bread and flour become scarce. February Revolution. Petrograd was given in the winter of 1917. There was heavy food shortage in workers' quarter. Parliamentarian wishing to preserve elected government were opposed to Tsar desire to dissolve Duma. On 22nd February, a lockout took place at a factory, followed by the strike next day. Demonstrating workers crossed from the factory quarters to capital. No political party organized this movement. Government imposed curfew and later suspended the Duma. Police headquarters were ransacked. People raised slogans about bread, better hours, and democracy. Cavalry called out by government to control them. Petrograd Soviet was formed by the soldiers and striking workers on advice of military commanders. Tsar abdicated Soviet and Duma leader formed a provisional government to run the country. Russians' future was to be decided by the constitution assembly elected through universal adult suffrage. Petrograd had led the February Revolution that brought down monarchy in 1917. Effect of the February Revolution. 22nd February, factory lockout on the right bank of the bank took place. 25th February, Duma was dissolved. 27th February, police headquarters ransacked. Regiments support the workers' formation of Soviet. 2nd March, the Tsar abdicated his power. The Soviet and Duma leaders formed a provisional government for Russia. The February Revolution had no political party and its forefront. It was led by the people themselves. Petrograd had brought down the monarchy and thus gained a significant place of Soviet history. Trade unions grew in numbers. With no monarchy to rule, the Russian future would now be decided by the Constituent Assembly, which was going to be elected on the basis of universal adult suffrage. October Revolution. 16th October, a military revolutionary committee was appointed by Soviet. 24th October, the uprising against the provisional government begins. Military Revolutionary Committee controls the city by night and ministers surrendered. The Bolshevik gained power. The October Revolution was primarily led by the Lenin and his subordinate Trotsky and involved the masses who supported these leaders. It marked the beginning of Lenin's rules over the Soviet, with the Bolsheviks under his guidance. The Bolshevik party after the revolution came to be known as the Russian Communist Party. Civil War. The aftermath of the October Revolution was beginning of the Russian Civil War, which was lasted from 1917 to 1922, with the Bolshevik Red Army trumping over the White Army. Once securely in power, Lenin enacted decrees that laid the groundwork for Russia becoming the world's first communist country. The Union of Soviet Socialist Republic was created in December of 1922. All Russian banks were nationalized and private accounts were confiscated. Church property was seized, all foreign debts were abandoned, and control of the factories were given to the government as well as all privately held lands. The lasting efforts of the October Revolution and the Russian Revolution was the beginning of the Russia as a communist country. That is the student, that is the end of Russian Revolution. Now, making of socialist society. The Bolsheviks kept industries and banks nationalized. They permitted peasants to cultivate the land that had been socialized. The Bolshevik used confiscated land to demonstrate what collective works could be. A process of centralized planning was introduced. Officials assessed how the economy could work and set target for a 5-year period. On this basis, they made the 5-year plans. Student, do you know that India adopted the 5-year plan from Russia? Centralized planning and led the economic growth. Industrial production increased. Now factory cities came into being. An extended schooling system was developed and arrangements were made for factory workers and peasants to enter universities. Cheap public health care was provided. Modern living quarters were set up for workers. Next system is Stalinism and collectivization. Lenin headed the Soviet Union till his death in 1924. Joseph Stalin took over the reins from him. There was acute shortage of grain in 1927. The government had fixed the price of grain but the peasant did not want to sell the government at these prices. Rich peasant of Kulaks were raided and grain stock confiscated. Stalin enforced collectivization of farms as a solution of grain shortage. Peasants were forced to work in collective farm and called kolkhoz, sharing the profit equally. This was not entirely successful as the production of grain did not increase immediately. In 1930, the Soviet Union faced one of the worst famines in the history, leaving over 4 million people dead. Global influence of Russian Revolution. In many countries, communist parties were formed. Many non-Russian from outside the USSR participated in the Conference of People of the East, and Bolsheviks founded Comintern, an international union of pro-Bolshevik socialist parties. The USSR had given socialism a global face by the time of Second World War. The style of government in USSR was not in keeping with the ideals of Russian Revolution. Thought it in its industries and agriculture had developed and poor were being fed, the essential freedom to its citizens was being denied. It was recognized that social ideas still enjoyed respect among Russians. Communism. Russia was the first country to establish communist state soon after the Revolution. Communist International Comintern was formed for promoting revolutions on an international scale. The revolution led to the formation of Communist Party in many countries, often with the support of Comintern. Socialism. Despite differences between communist and socialist, after the revolution, socialism became one of the most widely held ideologies. Popularity of socialism helped mitigate discriminations based on race, color, and sex. Democracy. The revolution led to redefinition of democracy. Most people began to recognize that for democracy to be real, political rights without social and economic rights were not enough. Economic planning. The idea of state playing an active role regulating the economy and planning the economy to improve the conditions of the people gained wide acceptance. Dignity of work. He that does not work, neither shall be eat, gained wide acceptance, adding a new dignity of labor. Internationalism. Socialist idea also helped the promoting internationalism by emphasizing nations think beyond narrow self-interest. Imperialism. The Russian Revolution hastened the end of imperialism. Russia, after the revolution, was the first country to openly support the cause of independence of all nations from foreign rule. Nationalism. The revolution awakened the people of Russia and Africa and influenced by new spirit of nationalism in their fight for freedom from the European colonizers. Divisions of the world. The world hence came to be divided into two, i.e. socialist and capitalist. The revolution gave a call to the workers of the world to unite against capitalists. Though by the end of 20th century, the international reputations of USSR as the socialist country declined, but the socialist ideals of the Russian Revolution still enjoy respect among the people of the world. So children, this is your chapter. I hope you will enjoy it. Thank you so much.